If your nerve deny you, go above your nerve.
Cheryl Strayed is an American writer from Pennsylvania. She graduated with honors in English from the University of Minnesota. In 1991, her mother died at the age of 45. After the traumatic experience, the theme of loss was to feature in many of her writings. In 1995, when she divorced from her first disastrous marriage, she changed her soon name to Strayed and decided to undertake a strenuous trek on the Pacific Crest Trail, which inspired her to write the book under analysis. In 1999, she remarried. Her daughter Bobby plays the younger version of Cheryl in the film. In 2002, she earned a Master of Fine Arts degree in creative writing from Syracuse University, where she was personally mentored by prominent contemporary writers. She is the author of 4 books, and her writing has been awarded widely in American magazines and anthologies. Wild, From Lost to Found on the Pacific Crest Trail, is her second and most important book, translated into 30 languages. The same week of its publication, the book landed among the top 10 New York Times bestsellers. Within the next month, Wild reached number 1 on the New York Times bestseller list, where it remained for several weeks. It later became a bestseller in several other countries. In addition to her 4 books, she has published essays for New York Times, The Sun, Vogue American, and The Washington Post. Cheryl is a broken girl. After the death of her mother, nothing has gone as it should. She begins a dark period in her life. She uses drugs and has numerous one-night stands. She is married, but her marriage is destined for a disastrous end. When she finally and painfully gets a divorce, Cheryl decides to change her surname to Strayed, and she makes another big decision to change her life around. Without any past trekking or hiking experience, one afternoon she bought a book about the Pacific Crest Trail, which runs from Mexico to Canada, and decided to hike it to Oregon, where she planned to settle down and start her life again. This is one of the few cases where the film has really remained close to the original work. The book is introspective, intimate. The author uses first-person narration, and this allows us to enter into the thoughts of the protagonist and get in syntony with her. It's like a stream of consciousness that Cheryl lets flow freely as she goes along her path. It was very gratifying to see how they managed to maintain that feeling in the film. The film is just as introspective as the book. We get in touch with Cheryl's thoughts and emotions in equal measure, and throughout the film, like her, we admire and realize how majestic nature is and how small and insignificant we humans are in front of it. The dialogues are neither long nor many, but we realize how unnecessary they are in this film. The message comes to us loud and clear right away. We are transported along with her on this wild adventure, feeling the same emotions as her. Our minds are as free to wander in search of our innermost emotions as her mind is. And eventually, as soon as the film ends, an enormous desire arises to plan a solo trip, an excursion in the middle of untouched nature. One of the main themes of this book is undoubtedly the pain of loss. We find it in many ways. First and foremost, of course, the premature loss of her mother when Cheryl was still just a girl, which left a deep scar on her. The loss of her husband, who, despite trying to be there for her during these dark years, eventually succumbed, and the divorce came. For Cheryl, it is symbolize another abandonment in her life, another loss of a person still very dear to her. Lastly, and above all, we find the loss of the oneself. This is the motivation behind the protagonist's decisions to embark on this long and tough journey, which for Cheryl is a path to recovery. She she is searching for herself as she was before her mother's death. Emotional pain mixes and turns into physical pain, and willpower helps her to overcome her suffering and to understand that it is part of life and it is useful to get better and stronger to face everything that life puts in front of us. What Cheryl does is not a journey to Oregon, but an inner journey that leads to acceptance and rebirth. The pain doesn't go away, but she learns to live with it. Something that is broken can be fixed. You can go back to the way you were, but you can move on. This is what Cheryl understands while trekking on the PCT. As we have seen, the theme of acceptance is also very important. Through the fear of facing a physical pain that the journey forces her to face, Cheryl accepts what she has been through, all the hell she has experienced and inflicted to her loved ones. She accepts herself, and finally, when she reaches the goal she has set for herself, she comes to the conclusion that everything she has been through has brought her exactly where she is at this moment, and that she wouldn't change anything about her life. Cheryl's co-protagonist during this experience is undoubtedly nature. Strong, wild, powerful, magnificent, and unpredictable. It was the challenges that nature posed to Cheryl that allowed her to heal her troubled spirit. Admiring nature in its purest and wildest form is something that is difficult to describe in words, a unique feeling that makes us understand both the caducity of life and its beauty. It makes us stop and think, thoughts that we then keep to ourselves, intimate and revelatory. We feel part of something, but at the same time, microscopic and powerless. I find Wild, despite its limited plot, to be a complete and compelling work. It constantly challenges us as we are pushed to question ourselves what we would do in the shoes of the protagonist. It pushes us to consider our lives as something unfinished, but something constantly evolving that we are always able to change and improve. It is emotional and strong, and it puts in front of us questions that we would not have the courage to face alone, and it teaches us that we can always find the courage within ourselves. It is a story that makes us reflect on our own lives, strong because it's true, told by a real person without hesitation or censorship, just with the desire to share their experience with the world, to show that even the life that seems the most destroyed and unstable can make it through. This is why I particularly enjoyed this book and its story, because we all feel lost from time to time. We all blame ourselves over something, but thanks to Cheryl and her testimony, we have proof that nothing is lost or unfixable.